beside you, feel free to call the office, leave a message. The best way to get in contact with you, and Ms. Harris or myself will give you the information that you need in order to be part of the church council, which is going to be on August 3rd at 6 p.m. Be as soon as you can call in as well. You might be surprised to see a big box at the entrance decorated with many school supplies, and that is because the young adult is collecting school supplies for the next two Sundays. There is a list on the box with more detailed information about what you can donate, what items that are required, when is the due date that you can bring it back, or if you want to make a monetary donation, they also give you some instructions how to do so. The goal, I think, that they set for this year is that they want to collect at least 200 backpacks. They trust in you and your friends to make this happen. Some of those school backpacks are going to be disseminated for the children, St. Paul, and the rest is going to be blessing the school of Valley and her elementary school. So we ask you to all of you to help us to collect as many school supplies and give a blessing to the children as they go back to school. And again, today we are kicking off our Vacation Bible School 2021. The name of the theme for this year is called Knights of the North Castle. That's why you see a lot of decoration referring to a castle. So, I'm going to mention the facilitators who are going to be watching. It's going to be again virtual. We're going to be posting the classes Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. It's going to be on Facebook or our YouTube channel at church. There will be classes for all ages, even for adults. So we invite you to log in Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. Invite family and friends. And this year, it is a small surprise. Every time that you will see the playlist, you will find a little link at the bottom. Once you watch the whole class, you can log in, answer a few questions, and you will get a surprise at the end of the Vacation Bible School. We want to be in contact, we want also to hear from you and to be blessed by what you learn by doing and participating in this Vacation Bible School. I also would like to introduce the facilitators that you will see on the different videos that are put together. So if you are here, I will ask you to stand up, and everybody, as you hear the names, you are more than welcome to clap. If you are not here, I invite you to wave your hands from home if you are watching online. So the people who are going to be watching on these videos, Let us do a call to worship. Settle us, O God. Remove or needless armor. Grant us calm.
Give us joy of the hearts and great mind, that we may be open to your grace.
Amen. Amen. Please remind us, standing as you're able. We are going to be introducing two songs. One is going to be the big song that is called Knights of the North Castle. The second one is called Be Strong in the Lord. I know that it is a new song, but I invite you to follow along as best of your ability. If you are able to move or follow the movements, I invite you to clap, and most importantly, I invite you to sing with joy. Be seated on the presence of
Like hope is nowhere to be found. book of 1 Samuel, chapter 17, tells us about one of the most famous battles in the history of the world. It all starts with King Saul, a very strong and handsome guy. However, as we learn later, he was not a great king at all. Therefore, God chose a small young shepherd to be the next king. He was the smallest and youngest of 8 sons. His name was David. This little shepherd really loved God. King Saul led his people in battle against their arch nemesis, the Philistines. They were not very nice people. When I said they were not nice, I meant to say they were very mean. Thank you. The Philistine army was very confident, and for good reason. They had a secret weapon, a powerful soldier named Goliath. He measured 6 cubits and a span. In other words, he was very tall. Taller than that. Taller? Close enough. Every day, Goliath yelled at the Israelites to send out someone to fight. All the Israelites, including King Saul, were too afraid to fight Goliath, so they did nothing for 40 days. Nothing, that is, until little David showed up to bring lunch to his brothers. While delivering food, David heard Goliath shouting at the Israelites, "Send out a man for me to fight!" So he volunteered. The king was unsure about sending a boy into battle. But David told the king about how he had fought both lion and bear to protect his sheep. "I will do the same to Goliath." The king agreed and gave David all of his armor to wear, but it didn't fit. Instead, David simply took his sling, went to the creek, and found 5 smooth rocks. Maybe try those smaller ones over there. With only his sling and a bag of rocks, David goes to fight the powerful Goliath. Now, it was Goliath's turn to be shocked as he saw David approaching. Instead of a strong warrior, the Israelites sent a small shepherd boy with no armor. "Am I a dog that you come at me with sticks?" Unfazed, David said, "You fight me with weapons, but God will win this battle." Goliath just laughed. Maybe a little more... Yeah, that's it. Anyway, David took a stone from his bag, put it in his sling, and flung it at Goliath. It hit him right in the head, and he fell on his face. When the other Philistines saw that Goliath was dead, they all ran away, and the Israelites ran after them. All of this was just as David said when he told Goliath, "Our God doesn't need swords or spears. God owns this battle, and he will hand all of you over to us and bring justice." And this is just one great story from the King's book.
And that was the story of David and Goliath. Let's continue now.
I just wanna dance, dance, dance.
That is why this morning we gather here to celebrate your goodness, to give thanks for all the great things that you have done in life, to surrender to you all the needs of our heart, all our trials and tribulations, in knowing better than anybody else. We come to you because we know that you are a rock, a refuge, a place where we can be healed and be sent out to continue our journey. As we embark in this quest to get to know the armor of God, to learn and to meditate on your word, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit. Be with us gathered here. Let the collective meditation of our hearts be presentable to you. I'm behind your cross, as my lips. And as we continue proclaiming your good news, that we will continue in making you disciples of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, people of God respond. Amen. Amen. I would like to say thanks to all of you who are being flexible to follow along with the songs. I know some of you that are trying to keep up. I also call for you who are watching us on Facebook, to the ushers who welcome us into this house and lead us into our seats, to Mr. Mitchell who will faithfully offer the gifts and help us to see the videos and the different outcomes on the screen, and to everyone who made possible this service. We give you thanks. Before I go into my message for today,
and I do not have this people put this video together.
when the words that David spoke were heard. David appeared then before Saul, and he sent for David. David said to Saul, "Let no answer fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with this Philistine." Saul said to David, "You are not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for you are just a boy, and he has been a warrior for his Jew." But David said to Saul, "Your servant is to keep sheep for his father, and whenever a lion or a bird came and took a lamb from the flock, I went after him and struck it down, rescued the lamb from his mouth, and if they turn against me, I will catch them by the jaw, strike it down, and kill it. Your servant has killed all lions and birds, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be like one of them, since he has defiled the armies of the living God." David continued, "The Lord who saved you from the paws of the lion and from the paws of the bear will save you from the hands of this Philistine. So Saul said to David, "Go, and may the Lord be with you." Saul clothed David with his armor. He put a bronze helmet on his head and clothed him with a cloth of mail. David stripped Saul's sword over the armor, and he tried in vain to fall, for he was not used to them. Then David said to Saul, "I cannot walk with all these things." Then he took his staff and his hand and chose five smooth stones for the body and put them in his shepherd bag, in his pouch. His sling was in his hand, and he drew near to Goliath. This is the word of God, the people of God, and speak to God. As we watch today's video, we hear from the world, we know that Philistines are on a pickle today. They are facing a different team that is called the Philistines. For those who are familiar with the Bible, you might know that the Israelites and the Philistines, they will fight several times. Why? Because they want to overrule the other team. When the Philistines won, they have more land to enjoy. When the Israelites won, same thing, they have more power over the other. So this particular morning, we find out the Israelites and Philistines again fighting one another. But the Philistines, knowing that they have a little advantage over the Israelites, they hit Goliath. As we hear in the video, that it was a big giant, a strong dude. Maybe somebody was brought up, a very intimidating person, and they say, instead of fighting each other, let's do one-on-one. We pick the best man, and you pick your best man. And whoever wins is going to win the battle. And as we learn, the Israelites were very afraid. They were hiding. And the scriptures say that the Goliath came three times every day and challenged the Israelites, knowing that nobody would stop out and face it because they might be afraid. I imagine the Israelites sometimes, like those children who have to face a bully at school, that they might know, feel that this person it's a little exciting. It's also some sort of fear to know what's going to happen. And sometimes it might look like a giant. But don't worry, children, boys and girls, because sometimes adults will go through the same thing. There's a time some of our professional career that really come to a crossroad whether to continue the job that we always done, but we are not so happy, or doing something that we think is going to bring happiness and passion to the heart. And when we are there ready to move forward, we sometimes paralyze as the Israelites, knowing that maybe it's going to be the right choice to switch careers, maybe it's not. Sometimes we try to seek guidance from your friends and family, but rather to hear good things, normally what we can list easily is the bad things. Why this person shouldn't do that? Why is the experience of other persons who have done this happening now? And we might be in that place as the Israelites, finally, not knowing what to do, not knowing if we can move forward. And sometimes, in order to bring some peace to our heart, we kind of make excuses and say, well, maybe this is not the right time to do it. I will wait one more year. Or once I save enough money, then I will try this new adventure. Or once my children graduate from high school, then I will try this new hobby. Or once I something new happens, I will try a different job. And sometimes we need people like David. Even with fear, brethren, I'll speak that word to your heart and tell us, let me do it for you. Because I know that the Lord who has delivered me from the paws of the bears and the lions will walk with me and face these new situations. Sometimes we need people who give us encouragement or who tell us, just like David, don't worry. This is the list of qualities that I see in you that you will have success in this new adventure that you have. Let's go ahead and pray together to God for the sermon and to find the right people or right things to do to continue moving forward. Or at least to tell us, I will walk with you. Let's do all our best and let God guide us to make sure that this is what you want. And sometimes we need people like David to step out, not because they are confident, but because they trust in the Lord. So many times we have seen in our lives how many miracles have God done in our lives that we are afraid to share to our children, to the people that we mentor, what God has done in our life. How many things we have seen done, things that we never imagined, lead us to the places that we never imagined to be on. Sometimes I just wonder about parents who rather the kids pass faith and confidence and love to the children, they pass their anxieties. And we see many parents running all over the place, putting their children into so much stress with different type of camps, different extracurricular activities, tutoring, sport activities, in order because we believe that in order that the children will be successful, they have to accumulate a big list of things that they have to have on their belt. But this morning on the scripture, we know that the most important thing they have to have on their belt is faith and trust in God and love from us. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying that all these things are bad. I'm not saying that to have your children on camps or sports is a bad thing. What I'm saying is that we should be the same passionate about our children going to camp or going to sport events, to be passionate to share our faith with them, to be able to then we'll put it down. And then we'll be sitting in the corner and afraid of the future. But if we share our faith, if we share our memory verses, if we install the Bible stories with them, we can be assured that whatever we're afraid, that we'll be trusting on God. And whatever God will lead them, then we'll have the people similar to David this morning say, I don't know what happened, but I know that this battle belongs to the Lord, and He will give you victory. And this morning, as we talk about the armor of God, the word for today tells us that the breastplate of justice will give us or shield us against any power. And we know that the children will be able to face any type of justice, knowing that they are loved by God, that they are loved by their family, and that they have a faith community to pray for them everywhere and every time. So I would like this morning, as we kick out our vacation Bible school, that we might not have children no more, but to find a young life that we can invest, that we can plug it, not with our armor, not with our fears, but with the trust in God. In the name of the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, the people of God respond. Amen. Friends, I'm very excited to start our vacation Bible school. Today we learn about the story of David and Goliath. Tomorrow we're going to learn a new story. If you want to find out, I invite you to log in at 6:30 either on Facebook or YouTube. Invite neighbors, grandchildren, children, anybody to go around and share this vacation Bible school. So before we dismiss from this place, receive this blessing. Heavenly God, we give you thanks because you love us with an armor and justice to do the right thing, not because it's convenient or because it's easy. You call us to do the right thing because you want us to build with you your kingdom of God. And we know what we might be afraid of, what might happen to us. We have your power. We have a family who loves, and we have a community of faith who call us to help us to continue your truth. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the people of God respond. Amen. So as you wait out, the usher is going to be receiving your offering. If you don't have your offering here, you can do it through Giblify or through our website. If you want to get more details to continue supporting the ministry, Paul is doing in this community, call us and we will be more than happy to tell us how can you support it. Children, youth, adults, and pay sales in the ministry that they do in this place. Now, as we close with our song for Vacation Bible School, let's be dismissed from this place. Amen.